إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد عبده ورسوله خير نبي اجتباه وهدى العالمين أرسله أرسله الله بدين الحق ليظهر على دين كله ولو كره الكافرون اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأزواجه وذرية وأصحابه وتابعين وتابعين بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد عباد الله أذكركم إياي بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى أذكركم بقوله سبحانه وتعالى حيث يقول في القرآن الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون أذكركم إياي بحفظ القرآن الكريم وسنة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله may Allah سبحانه وتعالى bless this gathering May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward the sincerity that has brought all of us together. I'll keep my remarks short, inshallah, but I just want to mention a few things. The first is that at the foundational level of us being here right now is that this has to be categorically based upon our collective return with istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, there are many things that could have occupied our time today. But alhamdulillah, we made the choice to come here instead of those things. So that in and of itself shows a care of our being here that is in itself the victory. Our job is only to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we can't ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala collectively if we are not present. So alhamdulillah, again, we should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving us tawfiq and putting it in our hearts to have iman and then to act upon it, to come here and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Imam Tahir talked about the animals and the children and the elderly, there's a hadith that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that if it were not for the elderly and the children and the animals, then I would not send my rain because of the disobedience of the children of Adam. So we have to ask ourselves then, what things are occurring in our lives that we know that perhaps are displeasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that would prevent His assistance, His madad. As is ordered in the Qur'an. إِسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبُّكُمْ إِنْهُ كَانَ غَفَارًا يُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ السَّمَاءَ مِدْرَارًا So that this essence that I talk about of istighfar, this is the Qur'anic ayah found in Surah Al-Nuh. وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبُّكُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبُّكُمْ May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us people of istighfar. Not only at this time, in our time of need, but in all times. Because as one of the scholars said that when we think that we don't need Allah is when we need Him the most. So alhamdulillah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this gathering a gathering of remembrance. That this collective return of tawbah, this collective return of repentance, this collective return of changing our state to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be one in which we can change the course. This is another thing that we have to be cognizant and aware of. That the conditions for our dua to be accepted is that you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your dua. Allah. We cannot be dissuaded, we cannot be persuaded, if you will, by the fact that people wanted us to believe that miracles don't happen. And what miracle is it for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make it to rain when there is no rain? If we believe that He is ala kulli shay'in qadir. This is the reality of who we are. This is what will separate the iman of the believer and bring them to a different relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which all of us are asking. Regardless of all of the science and all the empirical studies, fine, it has its place. But there are metaphysical causalities that exist when dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us in his book that if you want rain, if you want my assistance, then make istighfar. This is our message. It's not a complicated message. It's not a difficult message. But it's a message that requires our attention. And alhamdulillah, you have shown that it is people coming out here today that this situation has caught your attention. Another advice that I would give is that if we are ordered in our deen, or we are reminded in our deen that fasting metaphorically extinguishes the fires that are inside of us, then perhaps fasting and the dua at fasting will bring about a metaphysical extinguishing of the fires. That by fasting tomorrow on a Monday or any day from now, and at the time of breaking your fast, which is mustajab, that the dua is mustajab of the person who is fasting, that make an intention to fast with the intention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring ease, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring rain, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to stop the winds, as we saw this morning how intense the winds were. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will stop that, because that is a cause of the spreading of it. And that we are intentional, we have hudur, we have presence in our hearts with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala about the istighfar that we're making, that it is not just something that is on the tongue, but it's something that's coming from our core. Alhamdulillah, that there are people like yourselves that will come out to pray for takhfif. And we can think that we're not being affected by these fires, but we are. Just on a very subtle level, this air quality index is affecting every single one of us and affecting our children. Because it's not only the wood that is burning, it's fire, it is refrigerators that are burning, it's insulation that is burning, and it's all of these chemicals that are being placed into the atmosphere that all of us are breathing. We are being affected by it. So it's imperative for us who are not dealing with lost property or loss of life to take this time, alhamdulillah, and be intentional to make istighfar to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that He will send an abundance of rain. One of the things also we have to be careful with as well too, is that we don't try to connect our actions directly to a jawab from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that somehow we become dissuaded or disillusioned because, oh Allah, we made dua but you didn't send the rain. There are conditions for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in terms of our dua to even be accepted. We have to make sure first and foremost that those conditions are even being fulfilled. The other thing is that we risk creating a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are the Rabb and Allah is the Abd wa ni'udhu billah. That we ask and we say, well, where is it I asked you? Alhamdulillah that we ask. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what we need. We are not informing Him of what we need. He knows what we need. It's for us, alhamdulillah, to remind ourselves of our faqr. It's for us to remind ourselves of our impoverishment to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with every single breath that we take. And this is just a reminder for us. It's a reminder for us. A reminder of the damage of fire in this world, and a reminder of damage of fire in the next world. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لكم سائر المؤمنين يا قوم استغفر الله إنه هو غفور رحيم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما أمر وأشهد أن لا إله لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا مولانا سيدنا محمد العبد الرسول عباد الله وذكركم بتقوى الله سبحانه وتعالى كقول سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم حيث يقول في الحديث اتقوا الله حيثما كنتم وذكركم بشرف مكان المصطفى صلى الله عليه وآله وصحبه وسلم حيث يقول سبحانه في القرآن الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت وصليت على سيدنا إبراهيم Alhamdulillah, in closing, just a few words. That for us, this should be an opportunity or a moment of reflection that brings us into a greater increased state of shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because what differentiates the people who have lost their homes, who have lost families, who have lost perhaps everything in their life, except for a geographical place. Perhaps it is only where we live that has separated us. Not degrees, not any other things, ethnicities, status, whatever, it will mean nothing. And it should be a reminder to us, to increase us in a state of shukr, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't test us with that as He has tested us. And to be people, alhamdulillah, of humility, that will call on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a sincere belief that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is ala kulli shay'in qadeer. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can change any situation that He wants with kun. And then the response of it will be, fayakun. Regardless of what it is. Similarly, as the volcano was erupting and the lava was coming to Medina and they came out collectively, this is a reminder for us. Allah is Allah. And this is His creation. And He will deal with it however He wants, with whoever He wants, in a manner of however He wants. We have to have full yaqeen in that. May Allah give us yaqeen, inshaAllah. So inshaAllah, there's a sunnah to face the qibla during the dua. I'm going to turn towards the qibla, inshaAllah. We will engage in dua, inshaAllah, in our closing. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Hamdan biwafi ni'mahu likafi mazida. ربنا لك الحمد كما ينبغي لجلال وجهك العظيم سلطانك ربنا لا نحصي ثناء عليك كما اثنيت على نفسك اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى عن الناس اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى عن الناس اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى عن الناس اللهم خفف عن امتي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم ارحم امتي سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم O Allah, we are Your servants, Ya Allah. We ask You in this best time, in this best place, Ya Allah, to pour out Your mercy, Ya Allah.
Amen.
Ya Allah, we ask You to change this affliction, Ya Allah, on people, Ya Allah. We ask You to change it, Ya Allah, and to stop it, Ya Allah.
Amen.
Ya Allah, we come here with all of our sins broken and disheveled, Ya Allah, seeking Your mercy, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we are on the door, Ya Allah. You have reminded us, You have ordered us, Ya Allah, to ask of You, Ya Allah, we are asking You, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we have no other means to ask except for You, Ya Allah, do not turn us away, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, open up the skies, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, open up the skies, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, that is easy for You, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, there is not a cloud in the sky right now, but Ya Allah, with the order of kun, You can change that, Ya Allah. Give us the ability to believe in that, Ya Allah. Give us the courage to believe in it, Ya Allah. Give us the strength, Ya Allah, to ask You over and over and over again, Ya Allah, to change this affair, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, all of those that have lost in this fire, Ya Allah, return them with better than what they have lost, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask You for Your mercy, Ya Allah. We ask You, Ya Allah, to restore, Ya Allah, to restore Your peace and Your safety and Your security, Ya Allah. We ask You through Your blessed names, Ya Allah. We ask You, Ya Allah, to change this situation, Ya Allah. We ask You to make this situation better, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask You to change the direction of the winds, Ya Allah, and blow it away from the fire, Ya Allah. Blow it away from the people, Ya Allah. Blow it away from their property, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, give them sakina in their hearts, Ya Allah. Give them tranquility in their hearts, Ya Allah. Remove the anxiety from their hearts, Ya Allah. Remove the fear from their hearts, Ya Allah. And that is easy for You, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we ask You in this blessed time, in this blessed people, Ya Allah, in this blessed place, Ya Allah, that if there's one righteous person amongst us, Ya Allah, then accept their dua, Ya Allah. Accept the dua of the elderly, Ya Allah. Accept the dua of the children, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, inspire them to ask You with a great asking, Ya Allah, and You will return it with an even greater reward, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, don't turn away from us, Ya Allah, through Your generosity, Ya Allah, not through our deeds, Ya Allah. Through Your generosity, Ya Allah, not through our deeds, Ya Allah. We ask You, Ya Allah, to bless us, Ya Allah. We ask You to accept us, Ya Allah. We ask You to give us the strength and the courage to change our ways, Ya Allah, to a way that is pleasing with You, Ya Allah, so that we ask You, Ya Allah, that You will accept from us, Ya Allah. We ask You, Ya Allah, in this blessed place, in this blessed time, with these blessed people, Ya Allah, to make our best day, our last day, when we meet this world, we meet you. وَآخِرْ دَعْوَانَا عَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.